Hi guys, time for yet another tying video. So today I'm gonna do a new pattern for me. It's called the Artful Dodger, and the hook I'm tying on is of course from Graham Kelly. He makes really nice hooks, a huge amount of different models and sizes. So yeah, it's superb for the purpose tying classic salmon fly, since you can't really find these kind of hooks otherwise. So let's begin. First step, silver tinsel. I go with the extra small. I have waxed thread already, so the handmade hook by Graham Kelly. I'm tying on a 5-0. Let me put my glasses on, and everything is easier when I see what I'm doing. So, just gonna tie the tinsel in properly, somewhere there. Then I can reuse that part. Just gonna make sure the point of the hook is pointing in the right level. Then we have the silk, in this case it's orange, so I'm just going to see where it's gonna be there. Just tying that one in as well. Like that. So just tying that part in as well, securing it. going backwards. So it's tail time. And as you see, we have a level difference here. So I'm gonna level that one out, otherwise the tail is just gonna point straight up in the sky. Make nobody happy. There we are. So, let's add the tail. And before that, topping, ostrich herl, nothing else. Let's have a look at the pattern since I haven't tied it before. I don't want to miss out any step. I prepared a tail. Gonna have a quite low tail, and I intend to have a gap between the tail and the topping when I'm done. I don't aim for them to meet, so to say. And there the topping is straight on the tail. As you can see here. I'm gonna leave the pattern description in the description field in this video. So waxing the thread a bit, moving backwards. Then we have ostrich herl. Wraps of the ostrich herl. Gonna have a quite fat one. There we are. Tying it in a bit as well. Looks rather nice, I would say. More wax thread. Going backwards. Now it's time for tinsel. And it's gonna be flat oval tinsel and also oval tinsel, both gold. Thank you. just tying it in gently. Oops. That wasn't really gentle, but... And there we are. And we have the flat tinsel. This pattern, it states pea green, pig's wool. And here I got pig's wool. So let me just open that one. Gonna start with a thin layer of pig's wool in the beginning, so I don't completely cover the ostrich herl. I want to make it even more thin. Let's try that one. And somewhere there, I want to add a black hackle. Body hackle, cock of course. So I'm just gonna double the feathers. As long as possible, let me see. So waxing the thread then, and just tie it in. And then I can continue with the pig's wool. Looks like all over the place. The whole way, point of cutting anything there. So, back again, let's continue with the pig's wool.
Sorry for that.
Nice green color. A bit darker than Green Highlander. Almost there. There we are. So that room I'm gonna leave for finishing off the body hackle and then make room for the front hackle. That should be sufficient. So before we start with that, it's tinsel time. Just securing that one, cutting it off. There we go. Then it's the flat gold tinsel that will go just after, or behind would be a more correct word, the flat tinsel. Just securing it, few wraps with the thread, there we are. Then I'm gonna cut that one off as well. Now we're gonna do the body hackle. Just pulling the fibers backwards. I always finish off with a few wraps in the front. Just gonna move the thread forward. There they are. Now it's time to attach the front hackle. Just gonna finish off here. And have the fiber there. So I'm gonna cut the rib off. There we go. So, front tackle, let me see if it's too low. Yeah, I think it will do. For the front hackle, I took one feather off the side that is more soft. It's still a cock hackle. So I'm gonna start somewhere there. It give me sufficient for the front tackle. So I'm just gonna tie it in, securing it. Now it did break. Okay, just unwind all the thread then. The stem was too soft. So, and I have another feather. Maybe that was a sign it was too long, simple as that. So we try to be a bit more gentle this time. Just folding the fibers backwards. Maybe one more wrap. I'll take another one. everything. Just tying in the stem, securing it. So now the body is done. So I'm just gonna fold or give room for the middle wing here. It's gonna be golden pheasant tippet. As you can see, now I have a spot for it there. So I'm just gonna find a suitable one for this hook size. And then we can continue the video. So I got my tippets. I'm gonna tie them in rather rough. Make them long. Let's see how they sit. Spot on. They sit low as well. Maybe a little bit too low. So, looks good. There you see. Straight on. Next step is the wing, and this case is quite a simple wing, but it's not simple to mount it. It's cory and peacock tail feathers. So I prepare the wing here, as you can see. So I'm just gonna align it. There we go. So now so I'm just gonna slide it down. Let me see. Somewhere there. Too short. We got everything except a fiber. So I'm gonna see if I can remove the fiber. So, letting it go. Looks okay. Thank you. gonna have a look. Try to do. I noticed that this wing did stay on the it got stuck on the tippet. Now it's better. More aligned. And overall straight on. So what I'm gonna do now is to wax the thread. Just a few wraps with the wax thread. Then I'm gonna prepare two toppings and the horns. Not too much there. So I will restart the video in just a few minutes. I need to dig into my toppings and find two suitable ones. I'm gonna add the first topping of two. I think I will limit it to two, might add three, but the plan is two. Get those things away first. Waxing the thread a bit more. We're gonna do one topping at a time. Bit of varnish and then the next topping. The next one is going to lie. I might tie it in immediately. There we are. So let me then try to add that one. A bit high. I'm gonna try to lower it. Still rather high. it will sit lower. I'm waxing the thread first, just in case. Getting close, not happy with it. Now we have a much better look. So I'm gonna prepare horns and I'm gonna prepare ostrich herl. Time for the horns, and then I'm gonna tie in the ostrich herl, and then the fly is ready. So starting with this side. Waxing the thread again. Turning. Gonna have a similar height. Wrong side. So I'm just gonna trim a bit. There we are. Straight to the horn, to the ostrich herl. Just gonna back the thread. Thanks. Just gonna cut off the stem of the herd. So let's see how it turns. That way. Perfect. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna wax quite a lot of thread. Since I need to build up a foundation for the ostrich herl, so it doesn't slip off. Thank you. There we are. Whoops. We need to apply pressure at all times. I don't want to catch any herd or the cock hackle. So I'm just gonna sort out the herls. They're sorted. Fixing the hackle a bit. You can play around with the horns. Need to make sure they align. There we go. That's basically it. Sort out that. I wanted it a bit rough. So, that's how you tie the Artful Dodger. A nice pattern. So, that was it. The Artful Dodger. I'm gonna put the description in the description field on YouTube. Oh, this one is gonna be on YouTube, so hey. Whatever. Yeah, that's basically it. So see you in the next video. I'm gonna do with you so I can present a video each week when I'm in Thailand. I started to pack some tropical fly fishing gear, nice rod and reel, and a lot of flies. So yeah, it's gonna be interesting. See you in the next video. Take care. Bye.